Hello guys and welcome back to Madfire on channel. So in this tutorial series, we are going to create a simple puzzle game. In this series, we are going to check 8 direction swipe control, which will be used to move our player level generation from level data, then grid system and many more things. The entire project is available on GitHub. The link will be in the description. And if you want premium version of this project, which has extra features in it like AdMob, Unity Ads, Level Editor, 100 plus ready to go levels, then you can go to my Patreon page and get the premium project. And in this way, you will also support this channel. So without any further delay, let's get started. And let's change our clear flags to solid color. And our solid color will be, let's say, something this yellowish, light yellowish, something like this. Or maybe white, little white. Okay. Now we also need a swipe controller which can be used to detect the swipe. So for that, in our scripts folder, we will right click and create a new C# script, and we will call this swipe manager or swipe controller. Double click to open it in editor, and we will add it a namespace. Now our swipe controller will not be a mono behavior because it has just logic and we don't need mono behavior for it. And let's remove our start and update as well. Now to detect the swipe, we need two vectors, the starting vector and the end vector. So for that, we will create a private vector2 and we'll call this start pose, and we will also have end pose. So first we create a swipe enum and we add all the possible directions. So we have top, bottom, left, then top, left and all others. So we are having total 8 directions, and we also have a none. So just in case if the player tap and remove the finger, we will pass none at that time. So here we create a new method swipe direction which returns swipe. Then we create a variable called direction which is none by default. Then we get a current swipe vector2 by subtracting end pose and start pose, and then we find the angle. So to find the angle, we use mathrf.tan and we find the angle between our current swipe dot y and current swipe dot x. Now this thing returns radian and we need degrees, so we multiply it with 180 divided by mathrf dot pi to find a degree. So right now because we are multiplying it with 180, our angle is limited between 0 and 180 and 0 and minus 180. We cannot go for like set here 360 and get entire 360 because that will cause some issues. Now to understand like how we are going to detect whether it is left swipe or right swipe, let's go to some visuals. So here you can see, if I zoom in, we have this simple circle. Now the top part is a blue and the bottom is red. So this angle goes from 0 to 180, and this angle goes from 0 to minus 180. So this part is positive part and this part is negative part. Now if we divide 180 divided by 8, because we have 8 directions, we get some value like this. Now to find the right angle, what we can do is, we can say that, okay, the angle between 22.5 and minus 22.5, if we get anything between this, we will consider it as a right angle. Then for left, it is something like this. So anything between 157.5 and minus 157.5, if it is something between this, we consider it is left angle. Then for top, we have these two angles. Then for bottom, we have these two angles. And this one is top right, bottom right, and top left, bottom left. So these are the angles and we are going to use to decide which direction our swipe is. So let's go back to our script. And here we will have a lot of if condition. So okay, so as you can see here, we have added a lot of if conditions. So the first if condition is, we check if angle is between our 67.5f and 112.5f. So this is something between this. So if this is the angle, then we set our direction is swipe dot top. Same thing for bottom, then for left, right, and top right. So I have added all of them. If you want to know all of them, you can go to the GitHub link and just check the swipe controller there. Now after we have like decided what's the direction, here we check if our direction is not equal to none. If it is not none, then we need to send that information to our level manager, and then we reset our direction to none. So for that, what we'll do, we'll create a new method here. So we created a set level manager method here, and it takes a parameter level manager, and then we have created a local level manager variable here, and we assign that local variable manager in our set level manager method. Now in our level manager, we will create a new method. So depending on our swipe, we have to move our brush basically. So for that, we'll create a public void move brush method, and it will take swipe as an input, and we'll call this direction. And for time being, what we'll do is we will just debug our direction. So debug.log, and we'll debug our direction, and we need to create our swipe controller as well. So let's save this all, because swipe controller is a non-mono behavior and our level manager can create it the same way we have created our grid. So we create a private swipe controller, and we'll call this swipe controller. And in our start, we'll just set our swipe controller is equal to new swipe controller, and swipe controller dot set level manager and we pass this. Okay, so let's go back to our swipe controller, and in our swipe direction here, remove this and let's call our level manager dot move brush, and we pass the direction. So if we save all this thing and go back to our Unity, we must be able to see the debugs in our console. So let's clear all this. Let's click on play. So if I swipe up, okay, we are not detecting. Okay, one thing guys, we are missing. Actually, we are not calling this method anywhere. We need to call this method in update, but swipe controller is non-mono behavior and it do not have an update. So basically we have to create a method which will be called by level manager's update. So here we create a method, so it should be public method on update, and in that we first check if input.get mouse button down zero. If we have tapped the mouse button, then we set our start position equal to our mouse position and we set our end pose equal to start pose. Then we again check if we have released our mouse button, so this should be input.get mouse button up. So if we have released our mouse button, we set our end pose is equal to input.mousePose. Now before we decide the swipe direction, we need to check if vector2.distance between the end pose and start pose is at least greater than 0.1f. If this is true, only then we decide our swipe direction. So once this thing is true, we call our swipe direction. Now we need to call this method in our level manager. So if you go to our level manager, we have our swipe controller. Now in level manager, we'll create a update method, and here we will check if swipe controller is not equal to null, then we can call its on update method. So swipe controller dot on update. So now if we save this thing and go back, okay, we are having some errors. Let's see. Okay, we forgot to save this thing, so save it. Now let's try again. Okay, so if I swipe up, we get top, right, we get right, we have left, we have down. Then if we do top right, top left, bottom left, and bottom right. Okay. So our swipe is working perfectly. We are getting our correct directions. So the next thing will be moving our brush in our level.